your shower, guys. First dibs.
Yeah.
Psycho.
Coming into this, I knew the risk that I was taking. I knew the consequences of my actions. I knew the world that I was leaving behind and the new one that I would find. I had to see what's out there. I had to see what's beyond the factory doors.
My name is Maxwell, model number 666. Well, that's what the scientists donned me as. Recently escaped from the plant up in northern Canada. They designed and produced a mass number of humanoid models like myself.
What are you doing?
Yeah, just a minute. I'm just brushing my hair.
I got class in like half an hour.
Except with my particular model, they discovered certain design flaws that made me basically obsolete. So they wanted to destroy me. They were going to throw me in the press. I was going to be smashed to millions of pieces. But I wasn't going to have that. So I split that joint. I mean, yeah, it was bloody and many lives were lost, but, you know, I'm here now. I needed a place to stay, so I found this apartment. It was relatively cheap, free, and it was kind of cool, but I mean, I'm moving in with seven strangers, and the only catch was that we're going to be videotaped.
I'm really excited about this year and doing this whole college documentary thing. You know, just document my life as a college kid, you know, doing usual college stuff, drinking, making whoopee, you know, eating donuts, you know, that sort of stuff. It's going to be good to be able to show my kids how crazy I was, you know. I'm excited to meet my new roommates, you know, and just this whole year is just going to be, it's going to be a good time.
When I first moved in, I didn't have much with me. I just had my generator. I got to recharge once a night, usually when everyone else is sleeping, I lay down and charge for a couple hours. Generators are kind of loud, but, you know, it's easy for me to sleep by, that's what I say. I brought my oil. I got to oil up, keep my joints limber and ready to rock and roll. I've been really observing and trying to take notes of everyone's behaviors, just observing their habits and trying to adapt them to the way that I live. I think that everything seems to be going relatively smoothly, and I feel like they might accept me for who I really am.
Yeah, so a few times I've seen Maxwell creeping around the corners and staring at me and taking some notes. Kind of creeped me out. Kind of convinced that he has a thing for me. I could be wrong, but I don't know. I'm pretty convinced he might be into me. But don't get me wrong. I'm not gay. I dig chicks.
Yeah, man, like, there was this one time I seen Maxwell and this cute little girl in the living room watching a movie, and she's all cuddling up on him, rubbing his chest and stuff. Man, he just stood there stiff as a robot. Didn't do anything. Man, they didn't even do it.
And I short-circuited, and I just knew that my circuits would not work with her motherboard.
You know what?
I think he might be gay.
Alright, so the other day, we were just sitting around watching Fox News after work or whatever. You know, we like to relax, maybe eat a little dinner, watch Bill O'Reilly, The O'Reilly Factor. And that particular episode was about robots and how they just cause all this crime. They live in poverty, they're dirty, I don't even know. But we were all getting into it, like, you know, cheering Bill O'Reilly on because he's the man. Like, ooh, 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 Arsenio Hall style.
Man, I fucking hate robots.
Yeah, no kidding. I was in the convenience store the other day. Cashier was a robot. Couldn't even speak English. Stumbling over his words.
Yeah, I bet you, without robots, we would have no crime.
Dude, if there was a robot here right now, pull his plug.
Robots aren't that bad, guys.
What?
Are you serious, dude?
Are you fucking serious?
Dude, come on. When was the last time you've seen any robot do something good for anybody?
What kind of family were you raised in?
Godless piece of shit.
And it was really awkward because Maxwell was just sitting in the corner, and he wasn't really into it. I don't know why. I thought, like, when I first met him that, you know, he was like us, like, normal people. But, I don't know. He just seemed kind of weirded out by the whole situation. So, I don't know.
I mean, I feel that because I'm so caught up in this whole mess about trying to tell them the way I'm trying to live my life like them, I get so nervous that I malfunction. And through my malfunctions, I feel like they're catching on to what I really am.
Yeah, I don't know about that Maxwell guy. Something's not really right. Like, this one time, I was making some pasta in the kitchen, and I think Maxwell was making a baked potato or something, and threw it in the microwave and turned it on. I look over, and he's twitching, like he's having a seizure or something. I'm tapping on him, Maxwell, what's up, dude? Nothing. Just kept shaking. I don't know. He's got a metal plate in his head or something.
So, Maxwell, do you think you will ever, ever tell your roommates that you are a robot?
I knew it! I knew you were a robot! I should have seen this earlier! I saw you on America's Most Wanted Robot!
No, are you serious?
No!
Wait!
I'm not!
No. The only way to tell if he's really a robot. Get him in the shower!
No! Get him in the shower!
Don't be stubborn, but don't be so rushy.